once again, fellow adventurers. It is Old Gamer Joe back here with another Media Moogle review. Today, as promised, we are taking a look at the sequel to La Mulana, La Mulana 2, which has just recently been released here on the Switch as of March 17th of this year, 2020. It is again published by NIS America, available right now through the Nintendo eShop, and there is also a physical copy of this game coming out, which includes both games, 1 and 2, in one package, so you can look forward to that through NIS's website if you're interested. And well, this is a game that really feels like it was made for fans of the original and perhaps not anyone else, because in a lot of ways it is a retread of the same gameplay, though it does present its temples and exploration elements in new ways. It ultimately does feel very similar to the original game, so it's not a title that's going to change your mind if you were not a fan of the first one in the first place. So the setup for this game revolves around the original archaeologist Lameza Kasugi missing, and his daughter Lumisa setting out to try and find him. La Mulana 2 does try to tell a little bit of a deeper, more intricate story through its cutscenes, but ultimately I found them just to be kind of annoying because this is a game that is so based on exploration. The story really never feels as important as the gameplay, though I personally found it a little hard to care about any of the real characters in this game or the story elements, because the real magic of this series thus far has been in discovery, and while the increase in story elements doesn't really change that, it is a little bit cumbersome and annoying, and ultimately, I felt it was a little throwaway. Luckily, still, most of the text is easily skippable in this game, so it's not a huge deal ultimately, and you can get back to what this game is good at, which is giving the player a simplistic but really fun combat system which revolves around different accessories and items, as well as using your whip to take out the various baddies throughout the adventure. You will once again be solving some difficult and intriguing puzzles that are very cryptic in nature, though perhaps not quite to the level of the first game. In fact, in general, this game seems a little bit more forgiving, but I don't want to give you the illusion that this is an easy game, because it is still extremely challenging and very frustrating, as it is stuck in its ways with a very old archaic save system that will likely cost you a lot of treading back, just as it did in the original. Now, I know a lot of people out there refer to this game as a Metroidvania, and that's somewhat fair because you do have a pretty archaic block system map which you will have to use to not get lost completely throughout these dungeons, but the reality is it's the really cryptic and difficult riddles and puzzles in this game that will ultimately make or break your decision to want to play it, and so the spirit of adventure in this game feels just as relevant as it did in the original, and fans of that explorative element and mystery and intrigue are really going to get a kick out of the sequel just as much, if not more in some ways, because there are some nice refinements to the gameplay, though they are slight. I felt like the jumping was maybe a little bit improved in this title. It felt rather floaty in the original, and that's still there, but maybe just slightly better as far as platforming goes in the sequel. La Mulana 2 also looks really similar to the original game. In fact, I could argue that it's maybe not quite as detailed as the original. Something felt a little bit off to me, though it's not drastic. Still a nice looking game with colorful sprites, really cool dungeons and mysteries to be solved that all look beautiful, but just missing a little bit of the magic graphically of the original game. And it kind of carries over to the soundtrack as well, which is still really excellent, but I did not ultimately enjoy it quite as much as the original, though to be fair, those are lofty expectations to live up to, and it's still a very rocking, fun soundtrack that deserves credit on its own merits. Once again, the apps feature from the original game is put into the sequel, and you can equip them to get different abilities that help you solve mysteries, see maps, and other cool perks. This is a fun little feature that is exactly ripped from the original, so fans of the original will appreciate that greatly. The game is also lengthier than one would expect once again, with a 20 to 30 hour campaign. So just like the original, there's plenty to do here, and count on a few more hours for all the time you will spend wandering about, lost and confused. La Mulana 2 doesn't quite feel as magical as the original did, but in the end, more of the same is not always a bad thing, and fans of the original will absolutely love diving back into the temples, mystery, and lore that this series offers. For more on La Mulana 2 and all of our other content, head on over to MediaMoogle.net, where we have some great podcasts. And if you've enjoyed our video content today, please do hit the subscribe button below. Help us restore a voice to the voiceless in gaming today.